Airdate going inside. The running depth out. Shot on goal. A game winner for the Cavs.
A walk-off three-run shot from David Adams.
Feeds right on the cut back door. Up to the first layup.
A shot. Billing away the score.
Start the offense behind the cage. Up the left pipe.
Rubeor spins and scores.
Rostead is free. She scores. 10-5 on his feet. Touchdown.
Cavalier Sports Weekly is presented by the Virginia Lottery.
The Virginia Lottery, helping Virginia's public schools.
And brought to you in part by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. On this edition of Cavalier Sports Weekly, presented by the Virginia Lottery.
It's going to be hard to find something that's going to stop him from achieving whatever he puts his mind to, I think.
Welcome to Cavalier Sports Weekly. I'm Ben Rubeor, number 6 on the men's lacrosse team. We've got a lot of great highlights on today's show, but let's start with our play of the week.
The play of the week is brought to you by SunTrust Mortgage. We make the American dream come true every day.
I like being in that situation, and you know, I'm glad it was me today out there. You know, I love being in that situation with my team behind me the entire time. I love playing for the team, and you know, I'm very happy I came through this way.
There's probably nobody you'd rather have on the court in a pressure situation than Sam DeBarman. He's the most mentally tough kid I've ever coached, and he's like I've always said, that's what makes him a champion.
Stay tuned. Virginia game highlights are coming up next.
Sean, the ball fake. Deep three by Singletary. Yes!
Welcome back to Cavalier Sports Weekly. Our men's basketball team hosted the North Carolina Tar Heels earlier this week. Let's check out the game story.
The Cavalier game highlights are presented by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Man-to-man by Carolina. Entry going to Pettinella. Little give and go. Jones inside. Off the window. Good. Hansborough watching Pettinella at the post. Singletary off the bounce. Kicks to the corner. The three by Joseph. Yes, sir.
Nice setup by Sean Singletary.
I believe that effort is a given. You know, it's like a coach saying, hey, I'd like my team to play hard. That's what they're here for. And that's what we're here for. And my job and my chore is to try to play harder on a day-to-day basis than anybody that you compete against.
Mike Scott coming out. Jumper, good. Mid-range turnaround jumper over Hansborough. Joseph coming to set the screen, and now we'll rotate low. Lars sets it split. Singletary, 17, jumper, book it.
Nice job by Lars, and Singletary just cut off the screen.
When you play excellent basketball teams, the margin of error is razor thin. But any mistake that you make, you know, leads to something positive on the other end.
Screen set. Baker back outside Sean. Sean, the ball fake. Deep three by Singletary. Yes! Baker gets the screen from Pettinella. Baker fights through. The running floater. Teardrop. Good. Calvin Baker goes in the lane. Now with 8 with 7 seconds. They go sideline. Hansborough. Ball in the air. 15 mid-range. Good.
One of the missing pieces all year long is that the back line of our defense has been small and inexperienced. And to have a bigger body in there gives us a little bit more presence, gives us a little bit of a lift. Obviously, he's always been a crowd favorite. And so when he does something, he pumps his fist, it gets everybody a little bit more excited.
So the turnover by the Heels, and Singletary back. Singletary inside. And one! Layup good! Outside Singletary, 15 to shoot. They run it through the post. Lars, double team on Lars. Tries to protect. Layup, drop step, good. Mikolauskas goes to the rack. Singletary, the crossover. Sean gives it up. Baker. Baker spots for the three. Baker!
It's a tight ball game. It's just about every game is in this league. And you're going to have to find a way to get over the hump. And we have not done that.
Everybody knows wrestlers are tough. But Adam Fitterer has had more than his fair share of adversity to overcome. His quiet determination has been a constant presence on our wrestling team. And he is your Student Athlete of the Week.
I guess I always wanted to get in. This is my first choice. My junior year, when I was wrestling at States, I got into the semis and the coach gave me like a questionnaire. In the summer, he called me and we started talking then. I heard pretty late, like I had to wait like a month or a month and a half after everyone else found out until I actually got officially accepted.
I met him in the preseason, I guess last year, his first year. I mean, he seemed like a nice guy.
The coach emailed me and said, you know, we'd like to have you come wrestle here. And I guess that was like April 27th, 28th, and then my mom died a couple of days later, so it was kind of a up and down. My mom was in the hospital when I found out I got in the UVA, so it wasn't that sudden when she died, but she got to find out that I got in, so it was pretty big.
Actually, the first time I heard about it was secondhand, because he didn't relate it to me immediately, but a guy I'm living with now actually went to high school with Adam, so he knew the whole story. And so I didn't find out about that actually until pretty recently. And it was really surprising to me, just because, I mean, I had always just been so amazed by the way he handled the whole knee injury thing. And now I'm realizing that he's been dealing with something that just puts that, you know, just blows that out of the water in terms of how devastating it was for him. He just always had such a positive attitude, and he's just always looking to help other people all the time. He never really thinks about himself. So I think it'd be very easy in a situation like that to look for other people to help you out rather than putting other people first.
All sports in general bring like a balance to your life. I guess coming back to wrestling, you get back into the regimented day of going to school, going to practice. You know, it kind of takes your mind off of it. I went through the preseason, all the running and all the parts that are not fun. And then the second day of practice, I hurt my knee, so.
I had to take the blame for that one. That was actually me that blew out his knee. I just took a shot on him. We shook hands, and as soon as I took a shot, instead of being able to backpedal when I shot on him, his foot got kind of stuck on the mat.
When I stepped back to plant on my foot, on my back foot, and stepped on the side of my foot, and I guess there was no grip on the shoe, so it just slid out. My knee caved in. 4 months after that surgery, I just doing rehab and tore it again. I guess it was too loose, and so I had to go through it all again.
I think I remember a lot of people, especially after the second surgery, saying, well, he's not coming back next year. Why? I think just kind of assuming that. Why would he? I mean, who can go through all that and come back? And it was just a real joy to actually get on the mat and wrestle him a couple of weeks ago when he finally got cleared. That was just really exciting, because it was something I never actually thought was going to happen.
Our team's getting a lot better, so it's hard to keep up, especially, you know, I had a major setback about a year and a half, so. But I'd really like to start next year, so I'm going to be working hard over the summer, over the spring, and over the fall, I guess. That's why I guess it's a kind of a low goal for right now, but you got to take it one step at a time.
I think once he gets his skills back and gets the flexibility and strength back in his leg, and then if he does have to deal with injuries, we know he can deal with that too. So it's going to be hard to find someone that's going to stop him from achieving whatever he puts his mind to, I think.
Our men's lacrosse team opens our season today against Drexel in Philadelphia. So we thought we'd take a look back at one of the greatest teams in history in this week's Cavalier Flashback.
Cavalier Flashback is brought to you by the Virginia Lottery. More than $3 billion to K-12 public education since 1999. The Virginia Lottery, helping Virginia's public schools.
Hey,
Boy, that hit Matt Kelly, and Kelly, I don't know if that hit him in the helmet or if he got a stick on it. But the ball rebounds in the Cavs on a fast break. Rubeor goes low. Gladding the pass from Rubeor.
I think early, you know, in the first half, we were getting our shots, but I don't think they were really talked about. They're not being really good shots. I mean, fortunately, some fell and got a lead there. And, you know, we were up one at halftime in the national championship, and we're happy. And I think that says something about these bunch of guys. We came out in third quarter and really tried to get the shots, better shots on this kid. He's a great goalie. And just trying to hold the ball a little bit and work for the best shots that we did. Fortunate enough, we were finishing them.
Left of the cage, Poske. Poske to Gladding, back to Matt. Poske rips and fires left side. Matt Poske delivers.
But for us to come into the tournament and win out the way we were sort of expected to, there's a very special moment for our program, for all the young men involved with Virginia Lacrosse.
We drew Thompson. Thompson with a dodge right and goes right of the cage to Poske. Poske behind the goal. Poske behind his helmet scores.
Coming up after the break.
Driving in the lane, jumped off the little right, blocked the layup gun.
Our women's basketball team faced a pair of tough ACC opponents this week in Florida State and North Carolina. Let's check out the highlights in our Women's Basketball Spotlight.
The Women's Basketball Spotlight is presented by the Virginia Athletics Foundation.
Davis Kane with two, dribbling around, lost it, stolen by Stovall. To Monica Wright, down the left side of the floor. Wright dumps it back to Stovall, lays it in with the right hand. Lillard's beginning to wake up a little bit here. Here's Zoll, bounce pass to Lillard. What a great feed off the glass and good. The 35th bounce pass from Zoll. Another assist. So posting Mohammed, left block. Turnaround jumper on Monroe, missed it. Battle for the rebound. Mohammed took it out of there and laid it in. A strong move from Aisha.
I know that they know that they're in great position. They knew this was a big game. I tried not to overemphasize it, but they got the message, and I just knew that they weren't going to let this crowd down either. I just know how they are, so I just didn't feel like we would dump this game because we lost to Maryland.
Robinson posted on the left block. She skips it to Monica Wright on the right wing. Wright penetrating with the left hand all the way to the window. Lays it in with the left hand. Rebound Zoll. Cavs can take the lead for the first time today. Bounce pass left side to Littles. Lays it in with two hands. Off the glass. Virginia by two. 23-21 at 4:30. Zoll back door to Monica, who lays it in off the glass. Zoll to Mohammed, left baseline. She's doubled. Now left corner to Monica Wright. Skips it to Brittany Builder for three from the right corner pocket. Rolling home for Brittany Builder.
And I thought Brittany was the perfect answer because Brittany just put all the ball pressure we needed on their point guard, forced a lot of turnovers, and she was really, in my opinion, she was the key to the game today just because of the fact that she went out there and we had to match her energy.
Left side back to Monica from the left corner for three, in and out, no good. Rebound fought for and grabbed but picked off by Felicia Kellum. Kellum driving in the lane, the left-hand layup will go. Here comes Charnay Zoll at the point.
They just understand the game, and I think that Charnay's presence on the floor right now is just, you know, really unsurpassed. She plays at a pace that makes it difficult for every team in the country to play us. She just understands how we need to play and what our tempo is, and we're not playing at the other team's tempo at all.
Hands it off to Zoll. Zoll, a great no-look to Stovall down the lane with the left hand.
And today we just got out and we had to go. We had to go, 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 and she knew it, and she knew we had to push it, and that's really what broke the game open in the second half.
Back to the Cavaliers. They go right wing to Kellum. Touch pass to Little. Running down the lane. Well, good. Cavs up 14. Kellum, the crossover move to the right baseline, got cut off. Skips it left side to Zoll for three. Left side. Good. 2:10 to play. Zoll looking to drive left baseline. Zoll left baseline. Ray up with the right hand off the glass. Charnay with the hesitation move, and it's 73-54. Roll down the middle of the lane, kicks to Monica Wright, right baseline. The jumper from 10, missed it. Rebound, Mohammed lays it in with the left hand. So here comes Zoll. Zoll into the front court. Zoll at the top of the key, driving down the lane. Left hand, and the foul.
We came out and got a lead right away, and we came to play tonight. We weren't at all, like, in awe or, you know, it was just another game for us.
She'll come off the screen from Littles. looking for a posted Muhammad on the right block. She double stepped through and laid it in with the left hand. Off the high screen of Littles. Pick and roll on the Lindra on the right wing. She'll drive right baseline. The turnaround jumper. Good.
She's got a lot of responsibility. Probably wished I could have gotten her out of the game a little bit more and rested her a little bit more because, she was just playing her heart out tonight.
Back comes Zoll into the front court. Zoll to right on the right block. Layup good.
I guess that's a good thing that you can take out of it. It's helping our confidence because we can't say that we're getting blown out by other teams. Like, we're in these games, you know, we have leads and they're just playing a little better. And so we have to look at certain stretches of the game, and that's really it. It's not like we have to work on full 40 minutes or 20 minutes of the game. It's about 4 or 5 minutes, if that.
She's doubled, dumps it off to Jessica Braylon, who lays it in off the glass with the right hand. And it's 50-49, North Carolina with the lead. Zoll, left wing to right, driving left baseline, throws up the shot, missed it, rebound. Muhammad lays it in with the left hand.
Very smart basketball team and a very physical team.
Zoll, driving down the lane, dumps off to Robertson, the layup good with the right hand. 65-62, Virginia within three. Monica Wright, right wing. Right baseline to Muhammad. The layup good with the left hand. And Aisha is cleaning up.
She went out with, 6 minutes, 7 minutes? So we cut it. We were ready to win the game at that point without her. So, I don't think that really had anything to do with it.
Rebound to Zoll. Zoll coming out of there. Bounce passes to Kellum in the right block, finishes with the right hand. Wright driving in the lane, dumps off the Littles, right block, the layup good. Off the glass with the right hand.
Fortunately, we were not nearly as emotional in this game as we were at Maryland. I'm glad of that. We learned a little bit from that. And so we have to travel now. So we've got to be able to pick it up and go to the next level and go to the next game.
Our number one ranked men's tennis team is in Seattle for the weekend, competing for the National Indoor Championships. Here's an update on Samdev and the boys in our Olympic Sports Spotlight.
The Olympic Sports Spotlight is presented by the Virginia Athletics Foundation.
Okay. Go, guys.
Lots of energy, guys. Lots of energy. Every court.
Let's go, boys.
Let's go, boys.
We were as prepared as we have been for any match thus far during the year, and we came out and played pretty well in doubles. I thought they were extremely aggressive, and I was impressed with Penn State, particularly early on in the doubles point. I think they're an excellent team, and they're here for a reason, and we just got to continue to not look past anyone, take one match at a time.
Every opponent is really important, and you've got to try and do the best you can. Pacing is obviously important, but if you have playing against a good guy, you're just going to need to go out there and give it your best. We've done all the training, done all the fitness, all the rehab, and it just comes down to it now. There's not much more you can do. If you give it everything you can, you feel relaxed, confident that you can come out here and perform your best. And me and Houston, we haven't recently played a lot, but we've had this understanding of what is the best for each of us. And it really just comes out on the court. We just click right back into it as if we hadn't taken any time off. So we feel really good about our doubles.
In our singles, I thought we played okay at certain spots. Obviously, Sanam Singh keeps rolling and playing great tennis for us.
Shabazz and Sanam, those two guys, they look like they've been playing college tennis for 3 years. Someone like Sanam, I'm amazed. He comes out with the most unbelievable shots. He's just so fast, just so good.
Houston competing hard and continues to get the job done. And so there's some real bright spots for us. I thought Trett's playing better with each day. And the other guys, it was good for them to get a match in, and we'll just take it from there and see where we're at. You know, it's going to be another tough match tomorrow between either UCLA or Notre Dame, and we're looking forward to that opportunity.
Apart from being good players, everybody has a really big heart. I think every single guy on the team has got a chance to show that. I mean, I heard Dom was down really big in the third set and found a way to win. And, I mean, Teddy is always there for us. Sunam's just playing fantastic tennis, and, you know, even every other guy has a lot of heart. And, you know, I like to go out there and be the leader. And today I had a good chance, and, you know, I'm glad I took it. I knew my team was behind me. I knew I was excited inside, but, you know, I had to be calm, play my game the entire way, and then, you know, after that I can go celebrate with the team. I like being in that situation, and, you know, I'm glad it was me today out there because, you know, I love being in that situation with my team behind me the entire time. I love playing for the team, and, you know, I'm very happy I came through this way.
Thanks for watching Cavalier Sports Weekly. We'll be back next week with more great features and highlights. Until then, I'm Ben Rubeor. Go Hoos.
Cavalier Sports Weekly is presented by the Virginia Lottery. The Virginia Lottery, helping Virginia's public schools. And brought to you in part by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.